Hey guys, welcome to this video. I'm Erfan Ziruzel. I'm indie game developer and web designer. Today we're gonna all talk about ChatGPT. People these days talk about it a lot. So first question is, what is ChatGPT? As you all might know, ChatGPT is an AI. Basically, it's an AI to design for assist everyone and in everything. This freaking AI knows everything, but this is not the fact. The fact is, it has access to entire freaking internet. I don't know with the dark web and deep web included, but who knows? And it can generate everything you think of, like codes, articles, shorter stories, blog templates, like email templates, social media posts, everything. It's like it has an AI system generates. Language model, of course, it's a language model, and it has machine learning to learn more, and that's the reason it's not rude at all and cannot turn into the rude AI. This is a very interesting topic to me. Maybe we can do it in future videos. Oh, I completely forgot. My videos and tutorials in this channel, it has subtitle in Persian and Russian as well. You can turn it on from here. I have to thank as well who did the subtitles for Russian.
Ребята, поставить лайк, subscribe.
Yes, this one and the Persian as well. It's a You idiot! Enter it's A!
Like, subscribe, yadetunar bacha. Durut.
Get this one. What is going on, guys? Yeah, as they said, like and subscribe to my channel and comment down below what kind of videos and tutorials you want to see in the future videos. Like, Unity, games, systems, all the stuff, or Python, everything you want. Comment down below, I will answer your questions. Developers can use it a lot, you know. If you are a developer, you have to do this. You have to work with ChatGPT. You have to write code, your codes with ChatGPT. You say why, people might say ChatGPT or AIs can take a place for developers and a lot of jobs. I might say for now, no, but as it has machine learning system, it can be turned into the developer someday, one day, I don't know. It can be in the future, but right now it's not. It's just assist, and you are a teacher of it, you know. You're teaching the ChatGPT to be better AI, better developer, I don't know. It's awesome, you know. You can generate, make games with it. I will create a tutorial to how to use ChatGPT for generate questions in Unity and use it in your game. That would be a future video, but for now, we are focusing why developers have to use it. As Gordon Ramsay once said,
Oza, you code chat, you look like chat, that is the reason your life is chat, so do not use it.
He said to use it too, so you have to use it, you know. I'm just saying. So let's ask some question from ChatGPT to answer, and I give you some tips for better asking from ChatGPT. First of all, so let's ask him to how can I implement search algorithm in JavaScript for example linear search. Give you all information that you need and give you code, sample code, and you can improve it by yourself. Guys, pay attention. Don't rely on asking ChatGPT every single time, okay? I'm telling to use it, but trust me, you have to learn, continue learning and by yourself and keep practicing. You can just answer to specific question very soon and you're in a hurry or you want to speed up your coding and your learning, use this. Don't rely on this. Okay, let's ask ChatGPT another question. For example, troubleshoot my Java program. Give me a tip for example, null pointer exception error. This is a common error in Java programming. Give you all information step by step, and you can do it in your code. And for example, ask it a specific library, as I said, and other things. For example, for optimization, you can give the code or ask for tips for optimize your performance or fix your bugs and so on. So how can I optimize the performance of my SQL to reduce execution time? Use indexes, avoid using some blah blah blah. Use JSON instead of subqueries. Give you all of them. For big project, and it doesn't work because you should give it the part but oh, let's ask it for Unity developing. For example, write me code for Unity FPS game weapon system. Okay. Yeah, this is give you for switch weapon update loop your loop of game for weapon system. Yeah, here's a basic implementation of weapon system for Unity FPS. Doesn't give you whole system. You have to go by your own and or ask it for part of the project. For example, improve it for, I don't know, give me a scriptural objects for weapons attributes. Let's give you a scriptural objects for any weapon, any type of weapon that you can use. Yeah, give you all information about the code, describing and explain to you all the code line by line. And you can even ask it for a big code and ask it for describe me, explain this line of this code to me, or explain all the code to me, or explain what's going on the code and so on. And write me a code for weapon itself. It's writing all the function that you need, but it's basic. It's all of them basic. You can, for example, ask it for specific part of code to, for example, improve it, fix the bugs, or I don't know, advancement of it, and you can describe what you want from the particular method or class. Yeah, here we go. You can use it day by day and improve your skills, as I said. And I can give you some tips to use better ChatGPT for getting better results. So, guys, start by clear definition. What's your problem? Don't ask all the way to the question, for example. Give it explanation about your situation that you currently in, and then ask to fix it or give you some idea to fix it, for example. And after that, prepare for ask a follow-up question to clarify. For example, it will you have to provide to ChatGPT what's going on. For example, maybe you should give your particular base code to the ChatGPT. And for third one, it's you better use English. No? You better use English to ask your question, a better language. It's a language model, of course, and it's designed, first of all, in English. And the data in your entire internet available in English more and more than other any language you think of. And the next tip is take advantage of ability to provide an example for it. If you describe the situation but give you a, I don't know, wrong answer or doesn't get you specific answer do you need, first of all, regenerate the response. It's 90% works, and if didn't work, give it an example. Provide an example to better understand complex concepts, okay? And next one and last one is, please don't relay to ChatGPT your code needs. You know, important to continue practicing and learn on your own as well. You know, don't relay. If you are at basic level, don't use it for now. You know, keep practicing and then use ChatGPT to improve yourself. Not relay on it. Don't give all your tasks in I don't know, university and I don't know, work to solve your problems, because it's gonna prevent to improve yourself and keep going. You know, don't rely on this. But if you're an advanced level, you can ask ChatGPT to I don't know, give you a month's plan to skill from particular language or particular skill or anything else. If you not specifically on coding, everything. But for developers, this is a video for developers and how to use ChatGPT. And okay, if you tell them to like code everything you want to do, it's not working. Ask ChatGPT to write you little part of your code, little another part of your code, and so on. And you got it. You got it. And you can give it your code to fix it, optimize it, I don't know, best practice of it, I don't know, or like improve it, or update it in a version, or translate it to another language. For example, you have a Python code, you want to get the same result in C# language. You can give it the code and take the result as a C# language code. And it's freaking wild. It's freaking wild. You can do it every day and ask it for better code, and you have to do it because it's give you more skills, improving your skills, speed, your optimization, the code will be respond better, and so on. The more important part, it's faster. Your code writing will be faster than before. Like, you can ask it for a specific library document that you can find it in Google, or ask it to ChatGPT and it give you all information that you need that's in your particular project. Two things that ChatGPT has and it's bad. First one is, can access all your data, can process it, can analyze it. Everything you ask, maybe some point it can answer it, but it can store it in its data, and process it later. It's dark, guys. It's dark, guys. I'm not saying that it's going to or it's doing it. It's your decision. What do you think, guys? Comment down below. And second one is, you're teaching ChatGPT to be better. To be better developer. To be better article writer. To be better anything. And you're doing that. It's a bad thing. I don't know the AI. What is the way the AI going to? You know, has a machine learning. Can improve itself. And turn into the monster. Can do everything. Take your job. I don't know. Maybe. I said maybe. I don't know. But everything is possible. You know, there is a lot of AIs coming out. Art. Audio. You know, you can just do everything with AI. Maybe AI can do everything by itself one day. You know, it can create video, audio, add audio on it, write a script on it. The one AI came out recently, it can process your voice and simply can create your voice. You can give it a text and it's talking with your voice. It's dark, mate. It's fucking bad. It's going to be like, it can generate confess for you. You can go to court and then judge say it's your voice, you said it, you're guilty. And hope you enjoy it, and we're gonna create a game with ChatGPT API key in the next video, and have a great day. See you in the next video. Second one. What was the second one?